A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 14th December, on the front page you have Boris Johnson wins huge majority. So as his Brexit message has paid off, he wanted full authority to be able to take a decision on Brexit, and elections have shown the results, giving him a crushing victory. So Labour voters have deserted the party. So here you can see, that is, the Labour voters voted for the Conservative Party. The Labour Party could not hear. Boris Johnson is present Britain's PM too, and he has got a majority in elections. He's from the Conservative Party. Then this is, as protests continue, Shah cancels Northeast visit. So Home Minister Amit Shah has cancelled his scheduled visit to Meghalaya and Arunachal Pradesh. Though curfew has been relaxed in Guwahati, internet and data services are still shut in the region. And also India-Japan meet, which was scheduled for 15 to 17 December in Guwahati in Assam, has been cancelled because of the protests. These are protests against the Citizenship Amendment Bill. And then you have, Supreme Court says no minors were held in Jammu and Kashmir. So the Supreme Court has rejected the writ petition of activists relying on ground report by Jammu and Kashmir High Court Juvenile Justice Committee. So earlier also Juvenile Justice Committee had given its report, on which the Supreme Court had asked it to further look into the matter, take time and look into the allegations and then submit another report. But another report has also said there are no juveniles held. The previous report had said no juveniles are held, just based on what the police had to say, the police chief had to say. Police chief gave the statement, and that's what the Juvenile Justice Committee submitted as its finding. So Supreme Court asked, so it was a Supreme Court appointed committee because of a petition saying that minors are being held in Jammu and Kashmir. The committee and the police also say that they are being held as per the law. So now again, the Juvenile Justice Committee, its second report also says that no minors are held in Jammu and Kashmir. So court has rejected the writ petition based on this finding of the committee. Then below you have, Sabarimala temple issue explosive now, says Supreme Court. So Supreme Court says that women petitioners should have patience. So that's what the Supreme Court is saying, because now the issue is complicated and it has become explosive. So Supreme Court had given its ruling on right to entry of women in the Sabarimala temple, right to enter the sanctum sanctorum and worship. But then the people there are protests there going on there, that women are not being allowed to enter into the temple premises. They are stopped on the way to the temple too. And violence has been used against women too. Pepper spray has been used against women who try to enter and go towards the Sabarimala temple. So such has been the situation, and appeal has also been filed in Supreme Court. Supreme Court is going to hear the appeal, but it has not stayed its previous ruling. But now the police is also not allowing. Earlier police was helping the women devotees or women who wanted to visit the temple on the way, protecting them. But now police has also said that they should not be allowed there. It's not help, not assisting, as well as Kerala government has raised its hand. It is also not assisting. Plus Supreme Court also now says that the situation is explosive and women petitioners should be patient. Then on page 4 you have, hush hush executions a thing of the past. So this is regarding hanging of convicts. So Supreme Court guidelines, Delhi prison rules now make it mandatory for jail authorities to inform family ahead of hanging. So this is on that. This is Tihar jail in Delhi. And this is, Delhi government gives green signal to set up fast track courts. So fast track special courts, 16 more such courts would be set up to deal with sexual offense cases against women and children in the city. So in principle approval has been given. On page 8 you have, Assembly unanimously passes AP Disha Act. So Andhra Pradesh has become the first state to enact a law aimed at awarding capital punishment, that is death penalty, to the guilty in specified offences against women, and also it will complete trial in such cases within 21 days of crime. So this is post the 26-year-old veterinarian in Hyderabad who was gang raped and murdered. Andhra Pradesh has passed such a law. Also, special courts would be set up for specified offences against women and children. IPC, CRPC is proposed to be amended. This is mentioned here. On page 9, you have targets missed, Accessible India campaign's deadline extended. So, this is regarding Accessible India campaign that aims at making public spaces friendly for persons with disabilities. So, the deadline has been missed by the government and it has the scheme has been, campaign has been extended now. So, minister says due to slow progress, revised deadlines have been extended to March 2020 now. On the editorial page, the first editorial is regarding UK elections, the front page news today, the day of Boris. So, this is Boris Johnson who has got a significant majority. Labour Party lost and his Conservative Party has won seats. So, it is said Labour lost because it fought a Brexit election as if it were just another general election. So, this was an election which gave decisive power to Boris Johnson to complete Brexit, that is Britain's exit from European Union. And second editorial is Twin Troubles. So, this is regarding how inflation is rising and IIP is contracting. So, low growth and high inflation raise questions about the root cause of the crisis. So, IIP index of industrial production has been contracted. It is at -3.8% in October 2019, while inflation is high. So, if inflation is high, prices are rising, then why is there low growth? Then economy should be doing well. So, what is the cause of the crisis? Questions are raised on this. Then, the lead article is Savings with a Bonus. Financial peace of mind. So, this article says that government can ensure that Indian savers have access to simple fixed return products offering safety of capital. So, government should provide investors, Indians who save, who have savings accounts, to have fixed returns products. So, this is in the context of PMC Bank, Punjab and Maharashtra Cooperative Bank. When RBI put strictures on it and restrictions on the savings accounts also, where people have invested their savings, they cannot remove more than 1,000, more than 10,000 later. So, if such restrictions are put and the capital is in danger, people are affected. So, this article is talking of how government has the responsibility to ensure Indian savers get returns, fixed returns. And this is Britain votes for Brexit. So, this is the front page news too again. So this article by Karan Thapar talks of how Britain can be refashioned, UK can be refashioned by Boris Johnson, according to his beliefs. Then on Saturdays, you have this ground zero coverage. So, detailed coverage on one issue. So, this is regarding the encounter, exchange of fire which took place and the rape and murder accused of the young veterinarian of Hyderabad were killed by the police. All four accused had been killed. So, the ground situation is being looked into here. So, here you can see 1, 2, 3 and 4 been killed. Also, Supreme Court has set up a committee to look into the matter of these killings by the police. Plus, also NHRC has raised questions on it. On page 12, you have Maldives is negotiating China debt. So, Maldives is working with China practically to discuss its approximately $1.4 billion debt, is what Maldives foreign minister has said as such. He is on a visit to India. So, he differs from the speaker who had said that Maldives will scrap free trade agreement. So, this is regarding Maldives-China relations and how it would affect India too. So, the debt trap is what happens when China investments come and when the country in which investment is going cannot pay back. So, unmanageable debt. And this is center in talks with Jammu and Kashmir, Ladakh on special status. So, Ministry of Home Affairs is holding consultations with Union Territories of Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh to grant them special status on the lines of Article 371 of the Constitution. So, Article 370 has been scrapped. 371 gives special provisions for various states including Maharashtra, Gujarat, Nagaland, Assam, some regions of Maharashtra and Gujarat. So, now this is proposed that the two Union Territories would also come under Article 371. Then on international page, you have Despite massive victory, Boris Johnson faces a battle for Britain. So this is regarding the coverage on the elections in UK. And these are Indian origin candidates who also won in UK. This is EU warns of challenging time frame for UK trade deal. So now after the elections, government in place in UK with sufficient majority, European Commission president has said that will be a challenging time frame. Means it should quickly, now the UK trade deal should be quickly wrapped up. So member states means European Union member states. European Union has 28 members. After Britain exit takes place, Brexit takes place, there will be 27 members. So member states of European Union will not accept whatever it says blindly. So this is coverage on now Brexit as such. So Brexit, before Brexit, a trade deal is also essential, because how would Britain EU trade relations be after Britain exits European Union has to be finalized. So that is a step in that direction. And this is US-China pause trade war. So now USN and China have cooled their trade war, announcing phase one agreement that reduces some US tariffs in exchange for increased Chinese purchases of American farm goods. So now cooling off of the trade war has been initiated. So phase one has been put into effect. And on business page, you have exports contract for 4 month low, 4 month in a row. So imports see steeper decline at 12.7%, and exports have also contracted. So this is in the month of November, it is exports are at -0.34%. Imports also declined by 12.71%, means -12.71%. So when imports are declining at a faster pace than exports, then trade deficit has also narrowed. And here you have RBI Central Board meets over cooperative banks. So RBI Central Board reviewed functioning of urban cooperative banks and enforcement framework in the backdrop of the PNB scam, PMC scam, that is Punjab and Maharashtra Cooperative Bank. So the scam here affected lakhs of depositors. So this is in that context. And this is Moody's cuts India's GDP forecast to 5.6% for 2019. So slow job growth is weighing on consumption, and the growth forecast has been brought down. So also economic growth, it says, would pick up in 2020 and 2021. Then the last page has sports related news. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aashaw.com. Thank you.